This past week I saw the movie Volleyball starring Mohanlal New Film, and his own fans and fans of the director have been rebelling against it. Rebellion, I tell you, because it was kind of mismarketed. You know, expectations were high, and this was definitely a curveball to those fans, and so there has been a lot of negativity, which I'm likening to when you have that favorite artist or that favorite director, and they come up with something new, you know, and you're just like, what? It's like when Prince did Purple Rain he rode the hype for years, and everyone's waiting for his next drop around the world in a day. And people were like, what is this? People hated that album when it came out. Of course, over the years, it's been amazing. So I get a sense that's what's going on with this film. And I did a review, and it's gotten thousands and thousands of reactions. And the comments that we're getting from you guys is that, you know, people are just being unjust to this. It's not fair. Da 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 da. Listen, this film, Volleyball, is a cinematic bonker piece. It is bonker pieces, masterpiece bonkers. I absolutely love it. It's something you got to see on the big screen. It's so different. It's so strange. It's so weird. So what I wanted to do was bring up a I wanted to bring up a critic from India. And this guy, I followed this guy. This guy is fantastic. He kind of breaks down what this movie is and what it's all about. And I think it's pretty good. The fact that the lead star of this movie put this up, it's interesting. It's interesting. So let's check it out.
That shakes the roots of his existence, and also Taliban is not a regular film about a warrior, like, say, Oru Vadakkan Veeragatha. This is not a nationalistic movie with, say, well-written characters and so forth. It is a hallucinatory epic. Its style, Taliban is not a warrior, like, say...
Can I get a pause, please? Jesus. No. Get it there. He says it's a hallucinatory epic. 100%. It's not a nationalistic movie like a high end like RRR. It's not your ordinary action film. So he's right on the money that this movie is such a mushroom trip. It's so vivid, so cinematic that I'm throwing it out. You know, my mind, anything I want, I'm just gonna watch. You know what I mean, brother?
Yeah, no, it feels like it's more of a fear and loathing and, you know, type of ride where you're kind of going, okay, this is what it's going to be, and you're going to have to embrace it or, you know.
Well, okay, you use Terry Gilliam, and the thing is that it's not perverse like a Fear and Loathing. There's nothing perverse about it. It's good and evil. But cinematically, you're on point. It's as if Terry Gilliam was stuck in the 70s with Ang Lee, and they're trying to do a Bruce Lee film that's a Western, but then they're all high on shrooms. Right. That's how this movie is. And it's wild, man. It's wild. And it's got action. It's got incredible. It's an incredible story. The story is actually really simple. It's this man going from region to region, being
like an Avenger or something, or
no. When people try to call him out and they want to fight him.
Oh, okay. Kind of like a tough guy competition.
He beats everyone up, man.
Yeah.
But because he's the world's greatest warrior. But he comes from a very humble way. But this actor has been around since like the 90s. He's viejo. He's an older man, but he's perfect in this role. This man's eyes. This man's eyes, Mohan Lee, this man's eyes, it does all the acting. Not this critic, but the Mohan Lee. Maybe you can get a photo of him. And so, let's listen to this guy a little bit more.
Taliban is not a regular film about a warrior, like, say, Oru Vadakkan Veeragatha. This is not a nationalistic movie with, say, well-written characters and so forth. It is a hallucinatory epic. Its style is part of its very substance. And in the last half hour or so, Lijo does something fantastic and fantastical. So far, we have been watching a mass movie based on physical challenges, and now Taliban is faced with an emotional challenge that shakes the roots of his existence and also sets up the sequel. I like the deliberate pacing, which makes us feel
he's absolutely right on the money. Most of this film, and it's almost 3 hours long, most of this film is like him and his ragtag band go to a region, kick ass, go to another region, kick ass. He kind of flirts, he kind of falls in love, they eat a lot, they're funny with each other. It's kind of like that very Falstaffian and Henry the Eighth kind of like feel, where they're just going around the countryside frolicking. But then, you know, they stand up for the little people. It gets a little heavy towards the end. But then, like the last half hour, there's a total horrific twist that's has to do with their relationships. Their relationships. And it's a setup for part two. Man, it is really wild. It is really wild. This is cinema. This is cinema. This is how you do it, guys. This is how you do it.
That we have been transported to a timeless time. This gives the film the space to hold Madhu Neelakantan's shots and Lijo's choreography for a long time. There is a stunning dissolve effect where slaves running out of prison look like ghosts. And all this artifice is heightened by the deliberate use of colors.
Correct. So one of the last places that he liberates is a Portuguese colony. And I told Romy, because I'm like, hun, you talk about bingo card. I did not have it on my bingo card that I was going to go to an Indian movie and hear Portuguese. It's a Portuguese colony, and they enslave, like, you know, the local Indians there. And they're hysterical. They're like overhyped, kind of like hyper reality, like people of who they are. And but he's absolutely right. There's a point where the slaves are released from their bound from their prison, and you see they're you can see through them as they're coming out.
Oh wow!
It is a ride, guys. It's a long ride, but it's very worth it, especially if you're into cinema. Yeah, the movie's called Maliki Kotai Valiban. I'm just calling it Valiban.
Red in a bloody battle in a Portuguese colony, I think, and yellow in an episode with masks. I quote Valiban a lot, but unlike Nanpagal Nerathu Mayakam, I'm not going to label this an instant classic or a masterpiece or any such thing. I'm just going to call it a quintessential Lijo Jose Pellicheri film. Malaikote Valiban is...
There you go. And he's exactly right. You know, from what I'm getting from our hundreds of commenters and now hundreds of new subscribers, is that it's this director's, he's going off again. Like, this director does very unique cinematic movies, and they're huge fans of his. So yeah, I mean, I think that's cool. I think that's great. I think it's fantastic, you know. But yeah, there's nothing perverse about this film, guys. You know, it's not a Western film, like Western civilization and Western. You know, it is a deeply a certain part of India, and they use the Western as a kind of like this like long ongoing genre. But that being said, there's so many genres that they throw in there. It's truly a unique film. Check out my review. That would be fantastic.